Hey there, so ChatGPT has the ability to be able to create and edit images right inside of your free ChatGPT account. Now it's important to understand that your free ChatGPT account will give you limited access to image generation, but if you want unlimited access to image generation, you need the pro account. But even with the free version of ChatGPT, image creation is pretty much amazing, and I'm going to show you how to do it and some tips and tricks to get even better results. All right, so the very first thing you want to do is go to chatgpt.com and log in with your free account. And in the main prompt, the way that you're going to be able to ask ChatGPT to make you an image is just simply to say, create an image. So here I'm going to say, create an image of a dog wearing a Superman suit. And you'll see that ChatGPT will think about it for a minute. It could take a little bit of time depending on how busy it is, but it will eventually give you usually two options. All right, so you can see here that ChatGPT has given me two options. They're fantastic. They're just great, of this dog in a Superman suit. And to download any of these images, you just hover over the image and there will be a download icon at the bottom. You just simply click that to be able to download it to your device. So now let's take this up a notch where we actually use ChatGPT to edit an image after it's made it. So in this example, I'm gonna say, create an image of a newspaper page with a dog wearing a cape. So what it's gonna do is create an awesome image. It's gonna give me two versions. So I'm gonna pick the one that I like the best. I think I like this first one. So we're gonna go ahead now and tell it to add another headline to the newspaper page that says, Dr. Evil Cat is now behind bars. So now it's come up with a new couple of sets of pictures here where it shows a cat behind bars. So I'm kind of creating a fake newspaper story here. Now I'm gonna say, make the cat look angry and mad that it's behind bars. So now ChatGPT has changed the face of the cat slightly to be able to look a little bit more angry. As you can see, editing in ChatGPT is really simple. You just need to simply tell it what you want it to do to the image that it just created in order for it to make some different changes. The image creator inside of ChatGPT can also do some really cool things with referencing, such as memes. So for example, I'm gonna go ahead and upload a picture of myself and a popular internet meme. And I'm gonna say, generate this meme with my face and the caption being something about the questionable life choices that a 40-year-old makes. So now it's gonna go ahead and do that. And you're gonna see that it took some references from my face, added a caption on there, and it made two different versions. So it doesn't look exactly like me, but it is using the reference from that meme to create something similar, which is actually pretty cool. Another thing that ChatGPT can do is style existing images that you upload to make it look like something else. So for example, I could upload my picture again of my profile and I could say, make this a Studio Ghibli style photo. And you'll see here that it's made two versions and turned myself into a Japanese anime character. Now this is really cool because you can reference a lot of different styles and turn a lot of existing images that you have into something really creative and unique. Now to kind of piggyback off of this referencing and the things that ChatGPT can do, one really fun exercise is to take something that is very recognizable or some old ads and reimagine it into something new. So for example, we're gonna go ahead and take a look at these old Windows ads, right, for software that says sick of crashing. So I'm gonna say, generate an ad in the style of the old Windows ads for a digital marketing company called BKA Content. So you can see here that it made a couple of different versions. It's pretty cool. It's using the same sort of vibe and putting BKA Content on there. Now you can see that it kind of spells some stuff wrong. So I'm gonna try and prompt it here to correct its mistake by actually having it say digital marketing that works versus the other headline that it created. Now, this is kind of where you will notice that ChatGPT can sometimes get caught in a loop and have some issues sometimes getting all the text correct. So if you had a text editor like Canva or Photoshop, you can make these changes. Otherwise, you're just gonna kind of have to wrestle with it sometimes, which you can kind of see me doing here in this example of wrestling. I kind of got to a point where I decided, hey, I'm gonna just shorten that phrase from digital marketing that works just to digital marketing. And eventually ChatGPT was able to actually make that work correctly to where it was spelled right. So another really cool example is I pulled a Rosie the Riveter image and I put it into ChatGPT and I said, generate an ad image in the style of this old Rosie the Riveter ad for a digital marketing company named BKA Content. And what's pretty cool is it really did take the same sort of look and feel from that original Rosie the Riveter image and just gave me a couple different versions with BKA content. Now, some of this is cool because we don't necessarily want to steal or take things from the internet, but this is a really good way to kind of reimagine something or give you some ideas on what you could do that would kind of give something a similar or nostalgic vibe. And there you go. Now you have everything you need to start creating some awesome images using ChatGPT. If you made it this far, please make sure that you hit like, subscribe, and turn on notifications so that you'll be alerted when we put out more helpful content like this. And if you want to learn how to use ChatGPT to write really awesome content that Google will love and rank in its search engine, then make sure that you watch this video where we go over from start to finish how to use ChatGPT to write awesome content. So click on this video and we'll see you over there.